Yeah, I think space station is a good test bed to check out some of these capabilities that I described earlier. You know, like for example, in life support, you know, we still struggle with keeping our life support systems up and operating for an extended period of time. You know, they break fairly frequently. Simple things that we thought were not a technology challenge turn out to be a technology challenge to us. You know, some of the screens in our systems, they clog up with biofilm. It turns out that in microgravity, for some reason, bacteria proliferates. So internal to our plumbing and water supply systems, we get a biofilm or a thin film of bacteria that would typically pass through filters and screens on the ground or wouldn't even exist on the ground. It now clogs up our filters. Even small particles, you know, our bearings are designed to actually flake off small little particles as part of the wear process in bearings in water pumps. And what happens in the ground systems is if they get caught by the screen, they would stop. Or if they're small enough, they'd actually pass through the screen. But it turns out in zero G, for some reason, there's enough of a charge differential. And this microfilm, biofilm builds up on them, they will actually clog up a screen. So we size screens based on one gravity constraints. They clog up in a matter of weeks and the system is non-functional. So now we have to take our screens and we now have to open the area up to be 5, 6, 7 times more screen area than we would ever do in a terrestrial design. And we would have never picked that up. We never saw that in our life testing or in our ground testing on the ground. That was something we learned in space. We also learned that, again, the pH levels in our waters are extremely critical to this biofilm formation. It turns out that plastic tubing or Tygon tubing is permeable to carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide levels are a little higher in space station than they are in the ground. So then that carbon dioxide goes through the plastic tubing, goes into the water, changes the pH of the water, which then happens to make it now more susceptible to microbiology growth, and the whole system clogs up and stops working. And we did multiple year life testing underground, and we saw none of this underground because the CO2 levels were not representative of what we had in space, and then the microgravity or the gravity conditions prevented this biofilm from generating underground. So we never saw any of this in testing. So I say all that is that station is a great test bed to wring out all these unknowns that this long duration microgravity environment will show us from a hardware standpoint. Now the downside is station is still tough to get to, it's still tough to run a test in space, so there's a real resource commitment to actually do a demonstration or a test on space station. So it has to be something that uniquely can only be tested in space or has some inkling that you want to go do it there. I wouldn't recommend doing all testing on space station. You can do a lot on the ground. You can do, you know, procedures development, even, you know, undersea. You can do procedures development terrestrially. So some of that stuff isn't needed in space station, but you need to look at the unique aspects and environment of station and then only test those things that station can be actually used for to go do things. Another case could be is your Mars vehicle that you may transfer to Mars. You may actually take it into low Earth orbit and let it operate for a couple months in low Earth orbit to make sure that there you get through infant mortality and all the components that are going to fail in those first 3 months have failed, and that's behind you, and then you're in the sweet spot of the you know, we call it the bathtub curve, where there's lots of failures when a component is first built, and then it goes in a period where there's not many failures, and as it ages, it picks up more failures as it gets older. So what you could do is you could get through that infant mortality thing with an extended commissioning phase or checkout phase in low Earth orbit before you go commit to Mars. So there's lots of different strategies there, but station can play a pretty strong role in helping us, you know, understand how systems really operate in microgravity and what things we need to do differently.